1, 0. Ignition, liftoff, 10 for 5, aim high.
New information about the federal investigations into Hunter Biden's taxes, but sources telling Fox the investigation is actually bigger in scope. A Senate committee report may lay out a blueprint. It describes the son of the president-elect, his business dealings with China, and what is being called in the report the potential for criminal activity. Senior political correspondent Mike Emanuel starts us off with that part of the investigations tonight. Good evening, Mike.
Brett, good evening. This investigation, according to a source familiar, began in 2018. Fox News has learned not only are the feds digging into Hunter Biden's taxes, but he's also the target of a grand jury investigation. The federal investigation into Hunter Biden's tax affairs and business dealings was active in the final days of the presidential campaign, but it was covert to avoid influencing the outcome of the election. It's now in an overt phase. Fox has told his father the president-elect is not part of this probe. But a Republican member of the Homeland Security Committee notes Hunter traveled overseas when his father was vice president.
What did Joe Biden know and when did he know it? He needs to answer questions.
A source familiar says the investigation was established on suspicious activity reports regarding foreign transactions. Hunter's business dealings with Chinese nationals, including some flagged for potential financial criminal activity, are outlined in a Senate committee report. The chairman of Senate Finance, one of the two committees digging into Biden business dealings, says their investigation was justified.
The liberal media and members of the other political party chose to dismiss our work. They even falsely claimed that our work was Russian disinformation.
The Senate report notes, quote, Hunter Biden had business associations with Yao Jianming, Gong Wendong, and other Chinese nationals linked to the communist government and the People's Liberation Army. Those associations resulted in millions of dollars in cash flow, a point echoed by the Homeland Security chairman.
There have been reports of the Bidens cashing in on the Biden name for many, many years, you know, dating back to when Joe Biden was a senator.
Joe Biden and his allies were quick to dismiss questions about Hunter's business dealings in the final days of the campaign.
I know you'd ask it. I have no response. It's another smear campaign. Right up your alley. They're the questions you always ask.
I think that's a question that's been pretty well litigated in the last year as to whether or not the effort to bring Hunter Biden's history into this whole situation is a smear campaign.
Fox News was first to report that the FBI opened a money laundering investigation into a laptop connected to Hunter Biden. It's unclear if that portion of the investigation is still ongoing. Some Republicans are now expressing concern that with a change of administrations on January 20th, a new president and his team could replace the U.S. attorneys. Now there's a call that those spearheading this investigation must be allowed to complete their work without interference. Brett?
Okay, Mike, thank you. Hunter Biden is not the only member of the president-elect's family under scrutiny tonight. Some of the business dealings of Joe Biden's brother, James, also being examined. Correspondent Peter Ducey reports tonight from Wilmington, Delaware.
There's more than one Biden caught up in a federal investigation. Hunter.
Dr. Biden, can I share one thing on the news? A reaction to the news of the investigation of your son, Hunter.
And James, Biden's brother, whose name has come up in the course of an investigation into a hospital business he's linked to, according to a report in Politico. This is the same brother who allegedly introduced then-former Vice President Biden to a business partner.
I was introduced to Joe Biden by Jim Biden and Hunter Biden.
Jim Biden didn't want to talk about any of that when approached recently by FoxNews.com.
Are you Mr. Jim Biden? I wanted to ask you about the China deal.
Would you please stop bothering me?
Biden has promised distance.
My son, my family will not be involved.
But yesterday, the taxpayer-funded transition team sent out a statement from Hunter Biden, who doesn't work for the transition. Now, Mike Davis, former chief counsel for nominations at Senate Judiciary, wonders, why is Joe Biden using federal government resources to issue public statements for his son, Hunter Biden, related to his personal legal problems? Is this legal?
The very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society. And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings. We decided long ago that the dangers of excessive and unwarranted concealment of pertinent facts far outweighed the dangers which are cited to justify it.